Today we're going to be building a rugged gaming PC. Now I decided to do this after the postman already decided to test out the build before it was even built by leaving a massive dent in the side of the case. And then I thought to myself, well, with all this tough gaming going on with the Zeus, I decided to put together a tough rugged PC. But the purpose of this build was, Asus contacted me and said, Brian, do you want to build an all Asus gaming PC? And I said, well, at the moment, there's only a few PCs that I could see people, if you're a gamer, wanting to purchase. And that would be one involving either an RTX 3080 Ti, which I think is way too overpriced at the moment, or an RTX 3060. And these have the low hash rate limiters in them, so crypto miners aren't exactly targeting these GPUs as much as they target other parts. But then the rest of the components in the build, the power supply, we're going with a 750 watt Asus Tough Gaming power supply, 32 gigabytes of RGB DDR4 memory, Tough Gaming Z590 motherboard, and an i5-11400F, and an Asus Tough Gaming ATX case. And it's also got these straps on it so you can carry it around.
Brian, the straps don't actually do anything. Asus fooled you. It's only for show made.
But the best part about today's video is building this PC, Asus are going to be doing a bundle with all the Tough Gaming parts and the 11400F. Before we get into today's build guide, I want to say a couple of things. I was told the Australian viewers of today's video were going to get a competitive price for this bundle we're going to build, but at the moment they've just price matched the price of all these parts on their own, and the GPU especially is coming far above MSRP still. So basically, the bundle I'm building in today's video, I'm actually not going to be recommending it at its current price point. But with my prediction that GPU prices are going to continue to come down, I would personally hold off, and I'd like to see this bundle at least with a maximum price tag of 2,000 Aussie dollars or lower. Until then, I cannot recommend it, but of course, if you're building a new RTX 3000 series gaming PC, you may find this guide quite helpful. So let's get into it and build a Tough Gaming PC, which features the GT301 case, 750 watt Tough Gaming power supply, Z590 Tough Gaming Plus motherboard, 240 water cooler, 11400F, 1 terabyte SSD from Crucial, 32 gigabytes of DDR4 Kingston HyperX RGB memory, and the RTX 3060 V2 Tough Gaming low hash rate gaming graphics card.
So let's get this build started and see how it turns out.
And there we have it for the Asus Tough Gaming PC. It's finished, but there was a little bit of trouble in paradise. Well, actually kind of big, since it took us a lot longer to build this PC than I would have otherwise expected. This was due mainly to the GT301 case and the 240mm cooler, where technically, although compatible in that we have ended up mounting the 240mm water cooler at the front, we did so at the expense of wasting a lot of time in the relocation with the front RGB fans, which use 12 volt versus the 5 volt on the radiator fans, and also did so with very little clearance,
where we actually had to bend the case slightly to fit the RTX 3060 in after we did this. This was quite tedious and could have been easily avoided if there was more clearance at the top of the case, or instead, which I think is more reasonable approach, especially for the 11400 F6 core, would be to include a 120mm cooler in this bundle instead of a 240mm cooler. If this was the situation, we could simply then mount the cooler, the 120mm, at the back of the case and save a lot of time and hassle, as well as money. Though once completed, this PC is running very quiet. And since you guys have requested some tech, yes, Storm Spirit Dota 2 plays, it's time to test that out with the FPS numbers with a little bit of zip zap shock attack on the main map. And on top of that, you guys only wanted me to benchmark in heavy team fights, where I do agree with you, that's the most important time to have high FPS. So at 1080p, we got an average during these team fights of 160 FPS, and at 4K, it would get around 120 average FPS. Where at 4K in particular, the GPU was starting to get maxed out, and this was on max graphics settings, by the way, which I do prefer over lower settings, as this game is already quite old, and on low settings, it does look quite bad, especially versus higher settings. Though anything over 100 FPS is absolutely fine, as long as there are good 1% and 0.1% lows to match. And since Dota 2 works off a server tick rate, aka an update rate of 30 frames per second, it's fine to have all these FPS numbers that we've showed in today's video. Though onto a more demanding title, Cyberpunk 2077. Here they have greatly reshuffled the settings and details those settings give compared to launch. When I originally played this game, I'll say medium preset used to be the meta. That is the best graphical detail versus the FPS experienced. Now, however, it is about that high settings preset where the difference between medium and high is now quite noticeable, though the FPS drop isn't. Here at 1080p, we benchmarked low settings where we got over 120 average FPS, medium at 90, high at 79, and ultra at 67. Though what about DLSS? At 1080p, I'd prefer the native image over DLSS at low settings, for example, versus DLSS quality at high settings. Though at 4K, DLSS, especially on the balanced and quality profiles, does an amazing job of reproducing a high quality image and giving more FPS versus native. Though with ray tracing, it does work quite well with Cyberpunk. So if you'd want to use this, I'd recommend using the medium preset with an RTX 3060, and you can still get 60 FPS at 1080p. Though 1440p, and especially 4K with ray tracing on, FPS will start to tank, so I'd recommend turning it off at higher resolutions, and perhaps just using DLSS at both 1440p and 4K. So ultimately, Cyberpunk itself seems to have been better optimized to work with lower end hardware, though a lot of graphical settings have been shifted around to account for this, giving out a worser image for the same settings that were previously implemented in the game at launch. Though the final thing with today's build that I wanted to talk about is, of course, the temperatures and noise. With that tempered glass side panel on, both the CPU and GPU were staying under 60 degrees Celsius in a 23 degree ambient environment during Cyberpunk, which is quite intensive on both the CPU and GPU. And as for noise, I'm talking right beside this build right here, and this is as loud as it gets. So basically a very quiet build, though one final thing I will say is the straps on the front of the GT301, they don't do anything other than just for decoration. I'd like to see these straps be used for carrying the case, like the Helios, where they serve a function other than just looks, which would make it a great, tough gaming PC for LAN, since it is quite compact while fitting full-sized hardware. And also a bonus, the postman did this one for us. He already dropped the build on its side, testing the durability, and it still survived that. Though, of course, he dropped it on the metal side. If he dropped it on the tempered glass side, it would have been a nightmare. So never drop a PC on the tempered glass. Also, before I get on out of here, I'm sorry about the bundle's pricing. I tried my best, and when initially agreeing to this video, I thought, naively, there would be quite a big discount because it is a full bundle deal. Though that wasn't to be the case, but hopefully you guys enjoyed the build guide and the testing regardless, and that price should be coming down anyway. But at its current price, I am simply not recommending it. Though, with that aside, we got the question of the day here, which comes from Ace Centaro, and they ask, or you know, just play on native resolution. And they're referring to our Dota 2 FSR versus default resolution video. I'll put the link up here. And I completely agree, if you can play at native resolution and lower the settings versus higher settings with FSR on, I would choose the former, especially on Dota 2. I feel at lower resolutions in particular, FSR still has some ways to go. Hope that answers that question. And if you've stayed this far, then be sure to hit that like button, hit that sub, and ring the bell. And I'll catch you guys in another tech video very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.